There are over 32 million businesses in the U.S., and over 90% of them will never break seven figures in annual sales. So how do we as entrepreneurs or aspiring entrepreneurs break into that seven figures club? This podcast will relentlessly share the secrets, strategies, and tactics I've used to create three multi-seven figures businesses and bring in even more successful entrepreneurs than me to share their inspirational stories and tactics to success. You can create your dream business in life right now. So buckle up and let's go. Okay, welcome to the Seven Figures Partners Podcast. This is the initial episode of the podcast, and it's going to be delving into interesting topics, but as the name phrase is Seven Figures Partners, what we wanted to do that I thought would be unique is share true stories and theatrical presentations of how different strategic partnerships help businesses to grow, you know, by seven figures in multiple directions and so forth. And so that's what this podcast is going to be about. How can you harness strategic partnerships that are going to help you grow to seven figures or generate seven figures of business and be able to do it over and over again? And of course, we'll take a look at some true stories from guys like Robert Iger, the ex-CEO of Disney, and as he was able to buy Pixar, and some of the strategic partnerships that he put together and how important and vital those were for Disney to grow. So we're going to really look at that in this episode and in a number of future episodes, true stories about how these partnerships make all the difference. And we're not talking about, you know, people partnering up to go into business necessarily, but we're talking about different businesses coming together as strategic partners and harnessing their business direction where they're going and translating that into growth and success. And one of the keys to doing that, obviously, is relationships and building relationships. And so that's something that we're going to talk a lot about in this podcast. We're also going to talk about funding and the part that funding plays in creating seven figures partnerships and businesses, because we have a funding company. That's what we do. So let's jump right into seven figures partners and how vital and important this can be for any business. And the first story that I'm going to tell is kind of an interesting one that happened at our company recently. So we have a funding company. It's Seven Figures Funding, and we help new and small businesses get money to grow. And so this was a few months ago. This was early on in the pandemic. And oddly enough, one of our salespeople, Austin, was traveling to Costa Rica. And he was able to go to Costa Rica without problem, unbelievably, and go do some fishing. And so while he was gone, we were one person down. And so I had a little bit extra time and I started making phone calls. And I started calling some of our old leads. And I called and I texted and I emailed them and let them know that we still had the ability to get them financing even during this slowdown. And one of the ladies, her name was Jen, she contacted me back and said, hey, yeah, so I had this initial business idea that was going to be a CBD company, and I opted not to do that, but now I'm super excited about starting this e-commerce business. And Jen lives back east, and she is you know, an ambitious entrepreneur, but she's going through up and downs with her finances. She'd sold a piece of real estate, had made a lot of money doing that, and that money was starting to, you know, come down to the end where she was going to need to generate some more income, and she knew she wanted to do it with a business, and so e-commerce was her choice. And so I said, okay, great, how much money do you need? And we had to move some things around to make this happen for her. We had to help her pay a credit card balance down and move some money around to raise her credit score. So did that. She was very excited. She ends up getting, I think, about $35,000 in funding at 0% interest for a year. So pretty excited about that. And then I start to learn a little bit more. So why did you choose e-commerce? What is it about e-commerce? Oh, you know, there's just a lot of opportunity. And obviously with the slowdown, we see e-commerce businesses are the ones that are booming, are the ones that are doing well. So I definitely agreed with her there. And then I started to ask, well, do you have, you know, training programs? How are you learning how to do this? And she said, yes, actually, she was working with a group that had their own online academy.
And through this group, she had learned a lot about launching an e-commerce Amazon business. I was intrigued by that. So I asked her more information, and I eventually got the contact information, or at least the business name of the group she was working with. And so I thought, well, I want to partner up with this group, right? And what if we could do financing for all of their students that are learning how to start e-commerce businesses? So I started calling and texting and emailing, and I messaged them on LinkedIn, and I messaged them on Instagram and Facebook and on their website, and I opened support tickets. And then I went and talked to Jen, and I said, hey, if you could, you know, just mention us to the community and to the some of the management, your experience and how you're able to actually start your business now, because you worked with us. And she agreed to do it. And I told her, hey, we would take care of her, and we'd pay her a referral fee on every deal that comes in if she was able to help us out. So she, you know, shared her experience, and then the owners reached out to us immediately, and they were excited. It took a couple months to get it set up, but the end result was we had a couple hundred people that recently went and applied for funding through this partnership, through this seven figures partnership, and literally 2 weeks later, we had secured over $1 million in funding for 50 different students through this program, through this seven figures partnership, we'll call it. And so that's been a testimony to me to the value of these strategic partnerships. And when you put together great strategic partners, two different businesses that can come together and truly benefit one with another, then that's where there's a lot of magic and a lot of good things that can happen. And so the first thing I wanted to share was kind of my personal story. And then the next thing I wanted to share was a much bigger story, right? And recently, Robert Iger, who is the CEO not the founder, but obviously one of the chairmen of Walt Disney, and helped them go through some really tough periods and hit amazing growth, and did it with strategic partnerships. And so Michael Eisner was the previous CEO of Disney. And I remember Michael Eisner when I was growing up in the 80s and 90s. They'd have the Sunday Magic Disney movie on ABC, and you know, we would watch those as a family, and those were cool. And Michael Eisner did some great things for Disney the first 10 years of his career as CEO. The second 10 years of his career, not quite as successful, and Disney Animation struggled. And really, the only animation hits they had weren't theirs, but they were Pixar, who they did distribution for. And Michael Eisner didn't really get along with Steve Jobs, didn't really like him, and they didn't work well together. And so that was not a really good strategic partnership. And Steve Jobs, at the end of Michael Eisner's tenure, he's had it with him. He doesn't want to work with Disney. He's literally, you know, Disney's looking terrible in the public. Apple is on the upswing with the iPod, and Pixar is just killing it with movies like Nemo and some other, you know, early Pixar movies that just did extremely well. And so along comes Robert Iger, and he's been under Michael Eisner, but he sees the value of this partnership with Steve Jobs, with Pixar, comes together and immediately agrees to make ABC television shows available on the latest video version of the iPod. And so Steve Jobs is excited, and he does it easily without having to make, you know, Apple jump through a bunch of hoops, and it's a quick decision, and he makes that happen. And now Steve Jobs starts to see, wow, things are a little bit different at Disney. And because Bob Iger, you know, flies out to San Francisco, builds this relationship with Steve Jobs, this eventually leads to a multi-billion dollar purchase where Disney buys Pixar. And that never would have happened with Michael Eisner at the helm, because he didn't build those types of strategic relationships. But guess who did? Bob Iger. And then after he built, you know, was able to acquire Pixar, and Pixar Animation is the gold standard for all animation studios in the world right now. Next, he buys Marvel. What happens to Marvel? Well, you've got Avengers and Iron Man and Thor and all of those incredible movies that are multi-billion dollar movies. And it was because Disney bought Marvel that took place. And then next, the last step of the deal that Bob Iger does at that point is he then reaches out. What's the other one he buys? He buys Marvel. He buys Pixar. I'm trying to think of what the third one is that he buys. Oh, it's Fox. He buys Fox. Unbelievable. Like Fox that does movies. Fox that is Fox News and Fox TV that has NFL football games. It's one of the big four channels. He actually buys Fox. And now Disney basically owns everything that is Fox related. Whether you like it or not, it was a brilliant decision. And those three strategic partnerships that he put together have made Disney unstoppable. And now they've got Disney Plus. And they've got so many different ways to connect, but it all started with Pixar because animation was a key for Disney. Their parks, their consumer products that they sold, it all started there. So amazing true stories. Mine, smaller, but still a seven-figure story. Bob Iger's multi-billion dollar conglomerate story. But the important thing here is that for you as an entrepreneur, as a business professional, strategic partnerships are the key to success and quick growth. And they don't usually take money, they just take a lot of effort and the ability to build quality relationships. So my invitation to you on this first initial podcast is to make a list. Who are the different organizations and people within your industry that you could work with on a strategic basis and grow your business to astronomical levels? Or if you are an entrepreneur working in a business, who are the strategic partners you could reach up and reach out to that can make an enormous difference in your business? So that's our first episode on the Seven Figures Podcast. Have an amazing day, and we'll see you next time at Seven Figures Partners Podcast.
Are you looking for more seven-figure secrets, content, or even how you can launch your own recession-proof business? Then check out sevenfigures.com. That's the digit 7, F-I-G-U-R-E-S.com, where we share more videos, stories, strategies, funding solutions, entrepreneurial education, and even the secret business type that's recession-proof. Thank you for listening, and if you're finding value in our podcast, please give us a 5-star and invite others to join the club.